This is Alitta virens, also known as sandworm or king ragworm. Alitta virens is an annelid worm that burrows in wet sand and mud. It was first described by biologist Michael Sars in 1835 and classified as a polychaete in the family Nereididae. Sandworms make up a large part of the live sea bait industry. To fulfill the needs of this industry, some sandworms are commercially grown. Sandworming, or the harvesting of sandworms from mudflats, employs over 1,000 people in Maine. As of 2006, the population of sandworms had diminished greatly over the preceding few years, due in large part to overharvesting before the worms are able to reproduce by spawning. Sandworms eat seaweed and microorganisms. They have many distinctive traits, including often reaching great lengths, sometimes exceeding 4 feet, numerous, highly vascularized parapodia along both sides of their bodies, blue heads with two large pincer teeth which are capable of biting humans. The parapodia function both as external gills, the animal's primary respiratory surfaces, and as a means of locomotion, appearing much like short legs. Usually sandworms are gonochoric, meaning that they reproduce sexually between the males and females of the species, via a process termed swarming. The female sandworm releases pheromones that attract males to release sperm. Then, the female sandworm ejects eggs to have them fertilized. Found in the northern hemisphere where the water is shallow, brackish and temperate, they hide those pretty iridescent green, blue and yellow colors in U-shaped burrows dug down into the sediment. From here, they'll snare their prey of small worms, crustaceans and mollusks in much the same way as the dreaded bobbit worm, shooting up through their burrows to strike with their two pincer-like teeth before retreating back down to feed on their prize. But sometimes, they'll need to leave the safety of their burrows to scavenge for food scraps. And when things get particularly lean, they'll emerge to swallow the top layer of sediment so they can live off the nutrients in the settled detritus. At moments like these, the king ragworm is particularly vulnerable to becoming a meal itself. And in response to this, it's figured out a pretty nifty way of keeping watch for predators. In 2005, a team led by Gordon Watson of the University of Portsmouth's Institute of Marine Sciences observed the responses of king ragworms to three different extracts. King ragworm extract, extracts from its very close relative, Nereus diversicolor, and extracts from its common predator, the flatfish. The Nereus diversicolor extract didn't prompt much of a response, but the king ragworm extract prompted them to significantly reduce their feeding and other out-of-burrow activities, while the detection of flatfish extract resulted in more tentative feeding activity. The response of the king ragworms to this was nowhere near as spooked as it was when they detected extracts of their peers. The team suggested that this could indicate the use of chemical signals by king ragworms to judge the risk of predation in their area. For example, chemical signals given off by flatfish extract could indicate that there is a predator nearby, which is bad news. But chemical signals given off by extracts from other king ragworms could indicate that something in the area is actively damaging king ragworms, which is very bad news. The king ragworm was accordingly named the first known annelid worm, part of a large group of segmented worms that includes earthworms and leeches, to use chemical signals from other members of its species as a warning that there might be active predators nearby. This careful strategy could have something to do with the species' relatively long lifespan of 3 years, if it's not hauled up by fishermen for bait first. Close relative Nereus diversicolor typically only lives for about half as long.